with the lonely. The California raised us right. Kicking our feet routine, but what are we all trying to?
Oh no!
Worlds collide, paralyzed. Just in time, oh, two worlds collide, paralyzed. Just in time, oh, two worlds collide, paralyzed. Just in time, oh, two worlds collide, paralyzed.
One of the biggest differences between kangaroos and wallabies is how they are built. Kangaroos live in the wild, in the wide open plains and grasslands. They are built for long jumps and high speeds over great distances. On the other hand, wallabies tend to live in areas with dense vegetation. They are built for agility and quick bursts of speed, so their gait is made up of quick hops instead of long bounds, and the distances they cover are much shorter. That's a gray kangaroo. Swamp wallaby.
Then there's your paddy melons, which are the really, really small ones.
This one under here.
Yeah, so there'll be a really small one under there, which would be the paddy melon.
Paddy melon?
And your agile wallaby over there.
Agile?
Yeah, agile.
Yep. Agile wallaby.
Yep.
So this is the kangaroo.
The rest of wallabies.
The rest of wallabies. This yep. Agile wallaby.
Swamp wallaby.
Swamp wallaby.
And then the paddy melon should be under there.
Okay, thank you. Now, we can hand feed them, but are we allowed to pet them too or no? Are we allowed to touch them, like pet them or? Hey buddy. Wombat, affectionately known as the bulldozer of the bush. Wombats are the world's largest burrowing mammals. Australia is home to all three species of wombat, common southern hairy-nosed and northern hairy-nosed. Though they look cute and cuddly, wombats are highly defensive animals and will aggressively protect their territory from intruders. All wombat species are capable of digging extensive burrow systems underground. These vast networks consist of tunnels stretching up to 20 meters, as well as many shorter side tunnels and several entrances scattered throughout their territory. While the southern hairy-nosed and common wombat population are not of concern, the IUCN has classed the northern hairy-nosed wombat as critically endangered species. Habitat loss, predation, and competition with grazing livestock are just a few of the threats to the species. The entire population is now contained behind predator-proof fences in two locations in southeast Queensland, Epping Forest National Park and Richard Underwood Nature Refuge, so that the health of these individuals can be constantly monitored. There are breeding and reintroduction programs to help boost the numbers. The last census conducted in 2010 put the population size at an estimated 163 individuals, though it is believed that this number has risen in the years since.
They're very heavy. Okay. You figure this one out, though. Just feed the one next door, then I can tell you a bit about them if you'd like.
Yeah, quicker.
Wow.
Well, not silly.
What kind of food?
So in there is sweet potato, carrot, corn, apple, and some grains.
Oh, fruits and veggies.
Yeah, pretty much.
But how come that you gave it to him in a box like that?
Just to make it a bit more interesting for him. It's just a bit boring if he gets a new bowl every day. This way he has to work for it a little bit.
Oh, really?
It's called enrichment, where we just sort of enrich the animal's life, make it a bit more interesting.
So which wombats are these?
These are common wombats.
Huh?
Common wombats. We
have okay.
Three, the common wombats, northern
yeah.
hairy nose, and southern hairy nose.
Yeah.
So these are the common ones. This one here is Pugsley, he's about 9 years old. And then over here is Poppy, she's about 16.
16?
And that's her daughter Boo, she's 1.5.
Boo?
Yeah, she was born on Halloween, so we called her Boo.
That's cute.
Yeah, her dad is Pugsley next door.
Pugsley?
Yeah.
Oh, but you can't keep the dad and the mom together?
Yeah, he will try and mate with Poppy again, and Boo could get hurt in the process.
Oh, okay.
So we just keep them separate till we're ready to breed them again.
Okay.
Yeah. So they have a pouch, just like the koalas and kangaroos.
Uh-huh.
There's a bit different. When kangaroos hop in, it's frontwards. Uh-huh. When wombats hop in, it's backwards.
Okay.
They switch their pouch around.
Okay.
They've done that because of all their digging. If they had it the kangaroo way, it would fill up with dirt every time they bent over to dig.
The pouch is in the back,
yeah,
but they switch it around?
So if Poppy started walking away from
uh-huh.
you would see Boo's face through her
uh-huh.
legs.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, it faces backwards. Sort of like a pocket goes like this,
uh-huh.
and the opening is here.
Oh, okay.
So yeah.
Oh, okay, I see. It's backward.
Yeah,
upside, backwards. Almost upside down.
Yeah.
Okay.
So like normally the kangaroo, it sort of looks like this, and the
uh-huh.
opening's here. These guys, it's the other way around.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, and they just do that because of all their digging.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
They're very good diggers. They'll build tunnels and burrow systems underground.
Uh-huh.
And they spend most of their time under there because
uh-huh.
it's safe from predators and also temperature controlled.
Okay.
The biggest predator that would go for these would be dingoes.
Uh-huh.
These guys are well equipped for an attack. So
uh-huh.
if they were outside their burrow just eating and a dingo approached them, they could run away at about 40 k's an hour.
Okay.
So the speed of Usain Bolt, Poppy could race him if
okay.
she wanted to. And then she would run away from the dingo and reach her burrow, which just looks like a hole in the
uh-huh,
ground.
Uh-huh.
And she'd plug it up with her big bottom.
Uh-huh.
The dingo would then start scratching on her bum, trying to get in.
Uh-huh.
But it wouldn't hurt her because they have a hard plate here.
Oh, wow.
You guys hear that?
Yeah.
Very solid. It's made of cartilage, what our ears are made out of,
uh-huh.
and very few blood vessels, so she
okay.
won't bleed if he scratches her.
Uh-huh.
And eventually she'll get sick of the dingo scratching on her bum, so she'll make herself really flat. And then the dingo will try and climb in over top so he can bite up here.
Okay.
But once he's in position, Poppy would hoist up her whole body, and she could crush the dingo against the roof of the burrow.
Oh.
So very strong animals.
Okay.
Never follow them into a burrow.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
And if that didn't work, they always have sharp claws and sharp teeth. We do have a keeper who's been bitten here. And when these guys bite, they'll grab two pieces of skin, and they'll keep biting till their teeth touch. So
uh-huh.
you get a nice big circle scar.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
So they're eating fruits and veggies right now, but what else do they eat?
They also like grass. Sometimes you give them oats as a treat, but mainly in the wild they would eat grass and roots and different type of vegetation. So we just try to keep it a simple diet because they have sensitive tummies sometimes.
They live longer here?
Yes. Well, most animals live longer in captivity because they have better health care, better diet, safe from predators.
Mm-hmm.
Like koalas, 10 to 12 in the wild, 16 to 18 in captivity.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So yeah.
Oh, oh no!
That's terrible, don't bite.
That guy's a mean one.
He is mean.
I don't like him.
That's a wombat, right?
Yeah.
No, a kuaka.
Oh, a kuaka.
Oh, a kuaka.
Not very nice.
Not a
nice
one. No, that's so awesome.
Poor koala.
Look,
there they are.
Kuakas, only found on a few small islands off the coast of Western Australia, ranges from semi and scrub to cultivated gardens. Semi-arid scrub to cultivated gardens. Diet, many types of vegetation, mostly grasses and leaves and some flowering plants. Average lifespan, 10 years wild, 14 years captive. Conservation status, vulnerable. Did you know the kuaka is one of the first Australian mammals discovered by Europeans? In 1696, Dutch explorer Willem de Vlaming mistook them for giant rats and thus named them rottenness, today known as rottenness, which comes from a Dutch word rottenness, meaning rat nest.
Got all the grains and nutrients they need to sort of replicate the grass they would eat in the wild.
Okay.
But it's really good for them.
Okay. Thank you. Your name?
I'm Eliza.
Oh, okay. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye.
Oh,
thank you, Eliza. Appreciate
thank
it.
You.
Thank you. That's amazing. Look at this guy.
Nope.
Oh, he's trying to follow you.
Yes, he wants cuddles.
Crocodiles. You can see the crocodiles right there. These are freshwater crocodiles. Thanks for watching, guys. Still more to come in Kuranda, including Barren Falls, Sky Rail, and a guided rainforest walk. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you on the next one.
We are all running with the lone.